The Philippine Coast Guard has begun retrieving the oil cargo from the sunken motor tanker Terra Nova in Manila Bay. The vessel was carrying 1.4 million liters of industrial oil when it sank in bad weather in July. The Coast Guard says the siphoning operation could take at least a week to complete. Before this, it took 3 weeks to control the spillage and extract its fuel oil. Authorities say the oil spill from the Terra Nova has been minimal, but as a precaution, local governments imposed no catch zones, affecting tens of thousands of fisherfolk. Philippine Senator Francis Tolentino blames government negligence for the three sunken tankers in Manila Bay. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Victoria Tulad. Victoria?
That's correct, Ron. Government negligence led to the recent maritime mishap in Bataan, particularly the oil spill. This was the assertion of Senate Majority Floor Leader Francis Tolentino during the hearing of the Committee on Environment, Natural Resources, and Climate Change on the oil spill incident. Tolentino and Committee Chair Senator Cynthia Villar questioned the Philippine Coast Guard as to why motor tanker Terra Nova, motor tanker Jason Bradley, and motor vessel Mirola Uno were allowed to sail despite the bad weather. Terra Nova sank near the waters of Limay Town in Bataan. Jason Bradley capsized while it was anchored in Mariveles, while MV Mirola ran aground on the coast of Mariveles. Tolentino said, it appears that there is a semblance of laxity. Negligence is really prevalent in the country's maritime industry. PCG Commandant Admiral Ronnie Gavan said, however, that there was no prohibition on MV Terra Nova since there was no typhoon signal yet when it set sail. Meanwhile, the MV Mirola Uno set sail without clearance from the Coast Guard. Admiral Gavan also believes PCG regulations in allowing vessels to sail should be amended to adapt to new weather patterns and climate change. Tolentino agreed and said the government has to rectify its weather forecasting notices and how to connect this with real-time sail clearances as well as some of insurance liabilities. Representatives of MP Jason Bradley and MV Mirola Uno were subpoenaed by the committee for failing to attend the hearing despite being notified about it. Ron?
Victoria Tulad with that story. Thank you. The Philippine Health Department reminding the public to be more cautious due to the continuous uptick in both leptospirosis and dengue cases in the country. Rafael Bosano reports.
Cases of leptospirosis continue to be logged throughout the country, with over 250 cases reported from July 21 to August 3 based on data from the Philippine Health Department. But this isn't the only vector-borne disease that Filipinos have to look out for. Health workers are also reminding communities about the dangers of dengue.
Nakatutok rin po kami sa dengue kasi po ang dengue, nakakatakot rin po na sakit kasi nakakamatay po. Kaya sinasabihan po namin yung mga kabarangay namin na mag-ingat at maglinis. Huwag na po sana tayo baliwala sa mga sakit na ngayon po sa daga, tapos yung sa dengue po.
According to the Quezon City Epidemiology and Surveillance Unit, around 10 villages are now considered hotspots for dengue.
Kung isa lang ang incidence rate mo, pero maliit lang yung population mo, you can still be considered as a hotspot area. Kahit wala kang kaso pa ngayon, pero kalapit mo yung isang barangay na may mataas na incidence ng dengue, pwede kang masama dun sa hotspot na tinuturing natin. Hindi naman lahat ng kaso ng dengue ay nabibilang natin, di ba? So, yung mga nagpupunta lang na ospital lang o nagpapakonsulta lang, we assume na pag mataas ang isang incident sa isang barangay, marami pa rin doon kaso na hindi natin nakikita.
Health Department data also show that in the National Capital Region, Quezon City has the most cases. The cities of Marikina, San Juan, Caloocan, and Navotas also recorded more cases this year compared to 2023.
Ito ay isang seasonal disease, masasabi na natin, at nandun na tayo sa panahon na yun.
Mahalaga yung maagang pagkonsulta at testing para pag alam natin na dengue to, mabibigyan tayo ng karampatang lunas.
According to a report on the medical journal The Lancet, the DOH last declared a dengue outbreak in 2019, which affected almost 500,000 Filipinos. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.